Moving on to indirect pulp capping. Now, indirect pulp capping is just like direct pulp capping. The only difference is, suppose it is the pulp here, right? And this is the caries. Now, you can see how deep the caries is. So, when we go on to excavate this caries, what we do is, there might be a chance that if we excavate this last layer, we might end up exposing the pulp here. So, to avoid this, to avoid the exposure, what we do, we leave this caries dentin here. This part of caries dentin is left, right? And the cavity preparation is done up till here. And then there is placement of medicament to stimulate the pulp recovery, right? Why this is done? Because we try to avoid the exposure of pulp. So that is why we leave some part of the affected dentin. So by definition, it says that it is the procedure in which small amount of caries dentin is retained in deep cavity preparation to avoid exposure of pulp followed by placement of a medicament to stimulate and encourage the pulp recovery. So the indications are that it has to be a large caries lesion with no history of spontaneous or extreme pain. This point is important. If the patient complains of spontaneous pain, then you cannot do indirect pulp capping in that case. And the important thing to note is that we leave the caries dentin behind. So basically, we remove the infected dentin and we leave the affected dentin. Why so? Because infected dentin here, it cannot be remineralized. Whereas the affected dentin has the property of remineralization. So the dentin that we leave here can remineralize on its own. And the material used is calcium hydroxide or zinc oxide eugenol. Now, another important concept to remember is that the calcium hydroxide that we put here, what it does, it just provides the alkaline environment that is required for the reparative dentin to form. But the calcium that is needed for this dentin to form, that calcium ions, they actually come from blood and not from this calcium hydroxide. This is only responsible for the alkaline medium, right? This point is also important. So these are the steps. First, you remove the caries, you leave behind the affected dentin. You can see here that the caries dentin has three layers, necrotic or infected dentin. So you just leave the third portion here and infected dentin is removed. Now you place calcium hydroxide over this caries dentin and the final restoration is kept in place. So now we know that if a 7-year-old child has fractured his maxillary central incisor 5 months ago and the pulp shows no response, no response means we are talking about a non-vital tooth. There is no periapical lesion in the radiograph. So the treatment of choice is obviously apexification. Why? Because in all these three modalities that we studied just now are used in vital teeth. Whereas in non-vital teeth, we go with apexification. So that's it for this video. I hope you found this video helpful. Download our app for more videos. See you in the next one. Allah Hafiz.